I want to give you guys an update on the Cartmotor. Do a review. There's 8 batteries, 44 amp hour batteries. They're being charged by the pulse motor, which is currently putting 23 amps at 13.1 volts into the batteries. It actually, at this current time, if you look at this meter here, it's just a little bit above the plus side, because I'm basically bleeding off some of the energy. See, if I turn these bulbs off, you can see that's actually what goes to the batteries, but at the current time, I'm bleeding some of it off so I can shoot this without trying to drain 8 44 amp hour batteries. So basically we got 23 amps running to the batteries, and the input is 120 volt line, but it's showing 150 volts at 3.5 amps. The wheel's running 916 RPM, roughly, and we're bleeding off that energy. I've reconfigured it. It took less capacitors than I initially had set up, so I reduced the number of capacitors on the input, moved these over to the generator side. I've added a switch so I can kick in the generator. I can kick in the generator at whatever speed I want. So I've added a switch that I can turn this switch on, and that engages the generator. I'm not going to kick it in right now because basically all I have is 2 electrolytics hooked up from the negative side, and they're tied together at the positive. So there are no other polypropylene capacitors hooked to it right at the moment. So, but I wanted you to see how it's going. I'm still working on it. Need a few more solutions to really get it to where I want it. But my biggest problem is where to store the energy that it's creating. And one of the things I'm considering here, one of the things I'm considering is using heating elements as a power soak to remove some of the energy from the process, so that I can get a better idea of what's happening. Because when it kicks in, it just kicks in. It starts making power at such a rate, I have no way to control how much power it's making. So that's the biggest drawback right now I've found. So give you a look around the other side here. I put it up against the wall so I didn't have to worry about any stray flying objects. So cooking right along. I'm not sure if you're aware, but there's currently 11 coils on it, and the resistance is 4.7 kiloohms on the trigger, and it's still making a significant amount of power, and this amperage level increases the faster the wheel goes. So if you consider this, if the wheel's going 1,000 RPM, and there's 22 magnets on the wheel, that's 22,000 triggers that's happening within the span of a minute. So there's 22,000 triggers. And I'm really believing what I need to do is reduce the number of magnets, set them farther apart, to help increase the speed, because it pretty much maxes out right here. And that's, I think there's limitations to how fast this can trigger and collapse before it comes around again. So with 22 magnets on the wheel, I'm just getting too many triggers. If you can believe that. So And by reducing the number of magnets, it'll go faster, make the same amount of power, but it'll be able to go a little bit faster. So that hasn't been proven out yet. But I wanted to show you where I'm at and what I'm doing on it. We got a couple other projects going on right now that require my attention, and I'm continuing to do experiments on the cart motor. So for now, this is Technomancer from ZeroPointFuel signing out.